XL Construction is a sponsor here today with the design, build, and commercial teams for Cal Poly. What we do is really financially help support these teams, but also we're helping them be more successful in this competition just with our experience in the industry. Specifically, what we're doing today here is we've give them first a kind of an introduction to what the competition is about. Some of the students have been in the competition, some have not. After that, we break up into groups and really then start helping the students with their specific questions that they have about the problem statement. For example, of how do we put together a staffing matrix, or help us out a little bit better how to better schedule or understand how profit is calculated on a project. And then the second half of the day is really an opportunity for them now to do some practice presentations. And so each team is going to do, if you will, a dry run of their presentation to us. And then afterwards, we're going to give them some feedback on areas that they've done well or areas where they can improve on. I was actually part of the first competition that ever was held in 1988. I was 21 years old. For me, it was really one of those big aha moments going through the competition. And so with that, and how great of experience I had, I want to give back to the students that, and be able to share my experiences so they are able to experience the same thing that I did.
The six of us that came down today, it's really just a personal passion. We're all Cal Poly alumni. We had similar help in the preparation when we competed in ASC, and it's our kind of way to give back to Cal Poly and give back to these young up-and-coming students. The other big factor is it's a great way to recruit. You kind of get the top talent competing in ASC, and we are able to meet that top talent and then kind of pick the standouts amongst that group and then start engaging in a relationship with them early on in their education. The result is that we end up getting a lot of the high caliber and really talented students excited about coming and working with us when they graduate.
Oh, this was huge today. When we are in Reno, we're going to look back to this day and definitely remember all of the topics and remember all the tips that they did give us, and it's going to be extremely useful. I'm very grateful for it.
This is great. Like, XL is doing a great job in reaching out and being part of the community, and they're really helping the generation, present generation, to succeed in the future.
I really value the presence that big companies have on our campus and letting us see what the industry is like, and it really exposing us to what our future is going to be.
It's very impactful towards us because we are learning a ton today, and it really helps our presentation. So they're really committed to us, and they're showing it by coming down today.
XL Construction has given their financial commitment to these students and to the department. And I think it's more about our opportunity to give back.
Rosen Electric sponsors two students from each school who are part of the competition. This year there are 10 schools that are part of the electrical competition, and we reach out to the schools to select two people from each school from their team who is going to participate in that competition.
We even go so far as to book their flight and their travel and their hotel to make sure that we take care of the expense so that everybody has the ability to be here.
By having every team here, there is no advantage because everybody goes through the same opportunity and gets to go through a training piece with Rosendon Electric. So what the students do today, they have breakfast and then we start them off with some real life experiences. We talk to them about man loading and scheduling. We teach them how to do that. We do real life examples so that they can get hands-on experience. We also talk to them about the design build concept. And we go as far as reminding them safety on a job. We tell them that safety is a component of whether that job is successful or not. We teach them about their presentation, how to stand, how to relax, how to breathe. And we just try and make it beneficial so that they can go back to their school and teach the rest of their teammates on how to be best prepared for that competition.
We have our estimators, our safety folks, our training department all involved in providing ideas, solutions, and presentation skill sets to the participants in the competition to help them present better, to be more informed, to provide more competency to what their presentation looks like when they get up to Reno for the competition.
Our main goal, our main priority is to win. We like to compete as hard as we can, and we're trying to put everything in it, and I think this day today will be really helpful.
We're going through scheduling, how to break that down and from a schedule, how to take an estimate and build a manpower off of that, how to read scopes, how to create a proposal.
I'm very impressed with this day today. I've got 15 pages worth of notes that I'm gonna go back home and study up for this upcoming competition.
The goal here today is to get as much information as possible and bring it back to the team members and share that with everybody so that we can all be on the same level.
We are introduced to some of the best and brightest the industry has to offer. Those folks are in our building here today spending time with us. We get a chance to meet them. We get a chance to offer them a chance to come to work for us here at the company. And once they come to work for the company, we think they'll end up staying here.
These students have gone to these schools because they've chosen this to be their career path. It's the best way to find people who are in our industry and have a passion for it and want to work for good companies.
We have now kind of a team of people that are dedicated to the event. We've been doing this for 29 years now at Granite. So we've kind of got it down to a science. We have this team that comes together to select the problem, and then we sit down and have to agree on the different number of bid items, who's going to be involved. There are so many people from around the country at Granite that would like to be involved with the estimating competition, but we only have just a handful of judges. And so for us to even select who is able to participate is an interesting challenge because we have so many volunteers from across the country.
There's 25 to 30 employees here today. They're the binder graders. They're gonna grade essentially the estimate the kids are gonna put together. Today, we're gonna walk through, obviously we're gonna do the debrief, but we're also gonna walk through the scoring, how the scoring works, what the binder graders are gonna score on, and how that's broken down, just a little bit of what the score sheets look like, what we expect from them to do, writing good notes, giving good feedback to the students, and then go through the project. So if they have questions, they can ask now.
I'd competed in the competition for 3 years and eventually got linked up with Granite at the competition. Since then, I've been with Granite now as a full-time project engineer for 2 years and enjoyed what the company has to offer and enjoy coming back to the competition.
You know, this is something that we feel is important and we're dedicated to staying involved.
But we think it's well worth it. We all get a lot out of it. And it's not just from a business standpoint. Personally, our employees get a lot of satisfaction out of working with the students and just sharing their passion that they have about our work with them. For Granite, there's no doubt that we will always be in the competition as long as the competition is around.
At 5:30 Thursday morning, all the students come from 16 schools. And we'll hand out the plans, specs, all the rest of the handouts they're going to get, and off they go. Friday, 5 a.m., the 25, 30 judges are there for the binders. They start in, we spend about 2 hours judging the binders. 7:30, the presentations start. Presentations are 25 minutes long. They have up to 15 minutes to give the presentation to allow 10 minutes for question and answer. Friday evening, right after our debrief is done, we're going to have a hospitality suite in our room. Great time to get to know the students better.
We will have a hospitality suite this evening. We're inviting all of the students, faculty, other members from industry up to our suite to kind of unwind, rehash today's events.
Saturday morning, around 8 o'clock, the career fair starts. We have a booth at the career fair. A lot of HR managers from all over our region.
The job fair for Rosendin, we're hoping to identify summer interns for our company, for positions we've got across the country.
We get to engage in a deep relationship with these students early on, and in turn we end up with a lot of high caliber employees.
The level of expertise that you find every year, it just keeps ratcheting up.
We always come across some stellar students. Every year we get to hire a great handful of students from the competition. Pomona! It was really amazing to see the presentations come together for the students, and it was just amazing when they pulled it all together so well on so little sleep.
I was really proud of them to see the progression.
San Luis Obispo.
From the day we were in Cal Poly and to today, and specifically in their presentation skills, I thought they had a huge amount of improvement.
Obviously, they haven't slept much and they haven't eaten much, and they're exhausted, but they're still able to kind of get their game face on, if you will, and go out. And it was really cool to see, and I thought they did a really great job.
Well, at the end of the day, this is really our way to give back to the universities, to give back to the Associated Schools of Construction. It's really our way of giving back to the academics.
You know, it's almost like your child, right? It's awesome to watch how you're able to help these students and really feel I maybe had a little part in helping them get to where they've achieved.
I think I can attribute a lot of me knowing what to do with my problem, because it was a big curveball problem for us, to the help that I got from Excel, 100%.
I don't know what we would have done without them. To be honest, our training was really helpful from them. We had a lot of tools that they gave us.
It definitely helped with our, especially again, with the presentation. I mean, like, that was a really big day, and I think that really helped me personally a lot.
It's definitely a challenging experience, but at the end of the day, we're all rewarded with opportunities like this.
They give us this crazy project we have to estimate. It's crazy hours we do, but overall it's worth it. It's awesome.
It's definitely made a huge impact, and I appreciate every second of it and feel lucky to have this opportunity.